Sekarang.
Hai semuanya. Kembali lagi bersama saya, Brenda, dalam acara Brenda's Art Class. Bagi yang belum tahu Brenda's Art Class itu apa, ya Allah gerak. Brenda's Art Class itu adalah di mana Miss Brenda dan kalian dan guest star Brenda akan gambar atau akan ngelakuin sesuatu apapun lah yang berhubungan dengan seni. Jadi episode yang kedua ini kita akan menggambar gimana ya? Okay. Dalam episode yang kedua ini yang kalian udah lihat mungkin judulnya ada tulis yaitu Turn Anger into Art. Dan kenapa episode kali ini spesial? Karena pada hari ini Brenda nggak akan ngundang satu, tapi dua guestar. Brenda akan diundang oleh dua ilustrator yang kayak gimana ya? Mereka sangat edgy, mereka keren banget. Terus mereka ini pasangan kakak beradik dan mereka tuh punya image yang sangat gimana ya, mereka tuh image-nya kayak ditakutin gak ditakutin orang sih, soalnya mereka tuh menyeramkan gitu. Terus mereka ini sangat talented, jadi Brenda pengen banget ngajak mereka hari ini. Oke, kita sambut aja gimana untuk langsung. Untuk Ula, Zuhra, dan Karim Suharyo. Ayo datang. Tunggu ya kalau mereka belum ada. Tapi Miss Brenda juga lupa ngasih tahu ya minggu lalu. Ya udahlah, nggak apa-apa. Hai kalian. Apa kabar? Apa kabar?
Baik.
Ayo nih kita lagi ngobrol-ngobrol bareng aja nih. Gimana Ula, gimana Karim, situasi kalian stuck di rumah? Bisa enggak?
Belum show ini mulai udah deg-degan dikit sih sebenarnya sih.
Kenapa tuh?
Deg-degan show-nya gitu kan. Jadi
Wow, what people are watching us.
You know. Not actually though. Jadi enggak ada yang perlu di deg-degan, nggak ada yang perlu didek-dekan yang ini. Terus ya udah, kalian belum menjawab nih, gimana, bosan atau enggak, atau ada yang lagi di kesibukan kerjaan, jadi kayak nggak kerasa karantinanya.
Karim sih kemarin baru bikin podcast.
Radio, Karim.
Karim radio. Which I heard from my bedroom at 2 a.m. I thought he was having a fit or like spiraling into something lah.
It's a 50-50 thing.
Yeah. Terus gue gambar-gambar doang sih. Because I have nothing else to do, right?
Other than gambar-gambar working. Tuh gambar-gambar gimana?
Gambar-gambar aja.
Gambar-gambar aja.
Gambar-gambar. Gue lagi belajar bikin animation.
Lewat Photoshop.
gue nggak bisa bikin pakai Procreate or whatever.
Tapi rata sih really.
Whatever that is. Iya.
Karena penting ngelakuin sesuatu juga ya, nggak apa-apalah.
Iya, biar nggak ini aja berkarat.
Kalau radio Karim radio tuh gimana tuh?
I don't know. I was bored at 2 a.m. kemarin, so I kind of like. Ada beberapa lagu yang nggak kepake soalnya, jadi gue mikir kayak ini dimasukin aja ceritanya, bikin radio-radioan gitu. Terus skit-skitnya gue cuma ngobrol sama diri sendiri.
Terus bisa didengerin di mana?
Nanti malam mau diupload di Spotify, which will be up in a couple of days.
Kamu tuh belum upload ya?
Aku baru upload ke Bandcamp. Gitu doang. Cuman, I don't know if it's like a one-time thing or what.
It's pretty funny.
Thank you.
Okay, kalau gitu Miss Brenda akan dengerin ya, ntar kasih aja linknya.
Okay, Miss Brenda.
Okay, Bu. Zombie.
Aduh, pusing juga Miss Brenda pakai kacamata yang bukan kacamata Miss Brenda. Aduh, gimana ya? Lepas aja kali ya sekarang.
Tinggal di ini kamar arts and crafts, ruangan arts and crafts anak TK gitu.
She looks like a, apa namanya? What do you call that? Buronan.
What? Why?
Buronan, apa itu?
She looks like she's undercover right now.
Kayak 21 Jump Street gitu.
Iya, sambil jalan lewatin pasar terus kayak ngambil-ngambil barang-barang gitu. Rasanya tuh like what I'm seeing right
now. I didn't say it was that.
Enggak dong. Gambar ayo dong. Ayo Brenda harus pede. Brenda harus pede.
Miss Brenda.
Brenda, I'm older than you bitch.
Miss Brenda enggak. Miss Brenda, Miss Brenda enggak dong. Kalian lupa ya, Miss Brenda dulu ngajar loh. Ngajar kalian.
That's true.
Kan kalian pernah di Hadi Prana.
Oh iya.
Yeah. Atau Villa Merah.
Oh my god, Miss Ria has the same hair as you do, dude. Lo nyadar gak sih?
Miss Ria, dia pakai kerudung. Pakai kerudung Miss Ria.
Banyak yang ngajar Aduh, kita, yang ngajak, ngajak yang ngajar kita ngelukis waktu itu yang keren siapa sih?
Bukan Miss cowok, bukan cewek.
Cewek, cewek yang rambutnya juga udah putih. Ingat gak sih lo, seniman? Aduh. Oh, I used to go to a painting class with Nadine waktu itu, but she was very small at the time. Like she was like, I think she was SD or SMP, and I was like SMP or SMA, I cannot remember.
Enggak, tapi kalau nggak salah lah waktu dulu yang lo bilang apa namanya yang artis kerennya itu tuh di kelas yang udah advance. Kalau Miss Ria tuh yang masih kayak cimit-cimit, ada dua kelas lukis soalnya.
Tapi gue gak masuk kelas advance.
Lo sempet pindah ke kelas advance. Gue ingat.
Oh iya ya.
Jadi kayak, oh itu cewek pindah kelas. Oh dia udah hebat ya. Oke.
Okay.
Gue inget banget temen lo namanya Tamarin. Gue inget banget Tamarin. Gue kayak,
oh. Kayak Permen.
Permen.
Oke, jadi Miss Brenda mau nanya-nanya nih ke kalian. Kapan sih kalian tuh udah mulai tertarik sama seni gitu dan gimana kayak backgroundnya bisa jadi kayak sekarang perkembangannya?
I think it was selalu ada ya di keluarga ya kayaknya. Kalau menurut gue nyokap sama bokap tuh very artsy juga sih from the start dan kayak I guess dari dulu mereka juga nggak pernah menahan kita untuk kreasi kali secara seni in one way or another.
Dulu bokap kita sih suka gambar ya, and he was actually pretty good.
Tapi he only drew like naked bodies with flames.
Yeah, but that's exact point. Ngerti nggak sih? Like he was a man, he drew naked bodies
specifically with fire on the dick. Gitu.
But other than that, drew a very specific kind of looking man. That is almost like.
It's kayak gitu, like.
Yeah, tapi kayak godlike.
You know
what? Dewa gitu kan.
I think he was just trying to like copy paste Modesto.
You
know? sure?
No.
The figures are a little bit similar.
I don't know. Like that.
Berarti bidang mereka juga lebih ke media yang sama gitu, gambar gitu atau kayak seni lain juga.
Bokap kita dulu director. He was a commercial director. My mom, she changed jobs a lot. Tapi kayak dia selalu kayak nyuruh kita gambar,
mom's
nyuruh kita
cultured woman.
Iya gitulah. Terus dari dulu kita disuruh gak ditahan-tahan nonton TV gitu loh, kayak gak boleh. Kayak misalkan ada orang tuanya suka kayak, oh lo gak boleh nonton ini gitu. Kayak kita semua juga boleh, whatever gitu. Baca buku juga, whatever.
Iya,
yeah, well it's not different dude.
Ayo yang bener yang mana?
Lalu Ikarim ngomonginnya bokep anjing ya, iyalah. Gak boleh. Unless you were reading erotica, gitu.
I mean, there were always watching, like Basic Instinct and like all those like really sketchy DVDs you could see at home.
So. Not really. Yeah, got sketchy. Basic Instinct is an actual movie. Right?
It's not another teen movie. We had that on fucking DVD. There's so many movies.
That's also because our dad bought DVDs by the bulk. Like he didn't choose.
Yeah.
Kan lo inget kan kayak zaman-zaman ITC kan lo cuma datang terus kayak lo ngomong sama tukang kayak ada yang baru nggak, and then they come out with like
plastikan gitu,
langsung beli gitu.
Terus, oh jadi pokoknya backgroundnya udah emang diasupi dengan kesenian-kesenian dari orang tua, dari kedua orang tua.
Yeah, something like that.
I guess so.
Gitu.
Terus gimana kayak kalian ngerasain perkembangan kalian dari dulu ke sekarang dalam seni kalian?
Kalau
I think
musik sih ya.
Yeah, for me, kalau untuk gue emang lebih ke musik sih. Tapi kayaknya itu gue juga baru nemuin waktu SMA mungkin ya. Soalnya pas SMP nyoba ngeband dan segala hal, cuman emang nggak cocok aja kali ya seleranya sama anggota band yang lain. Terus nemu
band kamu apa namanya, Rim?
Kenapa Mil?
Band kamu dulu namanya apa, Rim?
Band aku dulu, there were like two names. The first one was this like shitty ass name, namanya A Boy Named Sid. I don't know why.
Oh no.
That's so bad.
Apa itu?
I don't know, man. Itu cuma nama bandnya, A Boy Named Sid. Man, I like the second name. It's Room Full of Phantoms.
Oh,
it's pretty nice.
It's
a pretty nice name.
Yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
Terus, yeah, I still tau-taunya SMA, terus belajar Ableton, and I've become more self-efficient to like make my own music aja sih.
Baru sekarang aku bisa nge-band lagi. Nah, sebelum permusikan, kan gambar-gambar juga kan sampai sekarang pun?
Yeah, I guess. Cuman, I think drawing is sebenarnya norak sih ngomong kayak gini sih. Tapi pas sampai hari ini sih, it's just like I guess it's a whenever I was angry, I would just draw, I guess.
Jadi cocok banget dong untuk episode yang ini.
Iya, bunda.
Oh iya, ada satu trivia juga. Dulu Karim pernah manggung di acara Kolibri ya, namanya. Coba ceritain.
I was terrible.
Was it Room Full of Phantoms?
Enggak, namanya Burma.
Oh iya, Burma. That's a great name.
It's a really great name. I was obsessed with naming any musical project by...
With just one word?
No, with like daerah.
Daerah.
Nggak sih, tapi jadi kayak Tuhan-Tuhan Buddha gitu.
Namanya Ethiopia.
Oh no,
They're
gonna
ask
for that now.
Yeah, tapi the song is nowhere to be found, so like...
Burma,
yeah, that was like, I was trying to like, to make, I don't know, like a folky thing? I don't get it, you guys see?
Ngapain? Main gitar?
Bising, yang pertama kali.
Iya. Wow, humble beginnings, man. That was a long fucking time.
So jadi Karim waktu itu gonjreng-gonjreng folk-folk gitu.
Yo,
kayaknya itu satu setengah lagi ya gue, and then I bailed out.
No!
Gue dekat banget sih saat itu.
Yang ngomong cuma tetangga dong.
Ih, jujur. Tapi itu kayak ajar nih semua yang dijual daripada gue ya. Gue takut banget.
Itu zaman masih
apa SMA itu?
Aku kuliah sih.
Kamu udah kuliah? Terus aku ngerasa bentar jauh banget gitu, kenapa?
Sama banget ya. Kita, ya sih. Itu rumahnya Dava bukan sih?
Rumahnya Dava.
Ya.
Pertama kali ya itu.
Yeah.
Gue belum, gue ya. Sorry, apa karakter.
Terus
kalau tadi Karim, kalau sekarang Ula gimana perkembangannya?
Ya, gue dari kecil sampai sekarang gambar sih, cuman...
Tapi you've always progressed, honestly, in terms of, like, quality.
Yeah, but I stopped drawing for a bit, like, at least, like, 2 years. Gue tuh nggak gambar banyak gitu loh.
Karena?
Gitu, I don't know. Ini aja, distracted. Terus, baru mulai gambar banget lagi, like, last year. Seluruh gue kayak jarang abis.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh iya, lupa juga untuk ngasih tahu kalian, waktu itu Miss Branda pernah ngadain pameran, dan Ula ini adalah kurator Anis Branda juga. Jadi Ula ini tuh salah satu dari kita. Ula ini tuh Tiny Studio juga. Waktu itu Ula juga pernah ngekuratorin. Wow. Jadi kalau misalkan ada orang-orang yang mau, you know, berkolaborasi sama Ula dan Karim juga, you know.
Yeah, now.
Tadi Ula udah jawab belum sih pertanyaannya?
Udah. Belum banget sih.
Ya bangetin dong.
Di jangka waktu yang gue gak gambar itu, gue kerja jadi pekerja seni lama. Jadi itu kayak kerjaannya berat sih. Jadi gue kayak gak gambar-gambar amat gitu. Cause I have to. Gue jadi project manager pameran. So, I've always wanted to work di dalam dunia kesenian sih, one way or the other gitu. Ya kayak gitu. Sebenarnya gambar itu cuma hobi. I didn't want to make money out of it. Tapi sekarang gue pikir kayak why not.
Jadi sekarang udah mau di lebih keseriusin juga.
Iyalah, because I have nothing else to do either, right? Kayak damn. Jadinya seru aja. You can make your hobby into money, I guess.
Iya. Yeah.
Aku setuju sama itu. Aku pun juga seperti itu. Lalu kayak kalian ada nggak sih punya inspirasi tokoh atau siapapun gitu yang kayak berpengaruh banget dalam karya kalian? kayaknya ada sesuatu nih.
You first lah.
Like everything you follow, I permeated towards anyway. So.
Apa ya? Let's think about this.
Kenapa you wanna sound cool? Eh? there's no such thing. Just say it.
Apa ya? Inspirasi berkarya gitu.
Apapun ya.
Good. I was thinking about this like a few weeks ago. Gue pikir kayak gambar gue tuh sebenarnya bentukannya tuh dari mana sih gitu. Kayak some people kan kayak misalkan lo gambarnya kayak gini and your main inspiration is this and it's like there's a correlation yang kayak ada benang merahnya banget yang lo bisa lihat gitu. And I'm like, terus gue nyadar kayak gambar gue tuh sebenarnya bentuknya jadi kayak agak kayak gini tuh gara-gara gue baca Junji Ito sih basically. I think that's it. Itu yang paling kayak jelas.
Jadi gitu. Kayak secara tidak sadar kayak udah ada di otak juga gitu ya.
Bisa jadi karena gue kan nontonnya kartun ya. Jadi makanya gue tuh enggak bisa gambar realis at all. Like when I was in college kayak gue belajar realis, gue sama sekali enggak bisa anjir kayak suruh gambar Christian Bale jadi kayak
Christian Bale. Ngapain juga gambar Christian Bale anjir.
Christian Bale, jadi kayak abang-abang gitu. Jadi gue kayak menyadari kayak, oh gue gak bisa gambar realis sama sekali. So I think I watch a lot of Nickelodeon with Karim zaman dulu.
We still do.
I don't anymore.
I still do, so yeah.
Kayak ya gitu dari situ, terus Junji Ito. Ya yeah, basically kalau buat gambar ya itu sih. Untuk inspirasi bentuk langsung ya, kayak basically I think mostly graphic novelists kayak.
I think Daniel Klaus kind of.
Daniel Klaus and
really
Charles Burns. Orang kan gue kan sebenarnya nggak terlalu before like this year I didn't use a lot of color. Gue kayak hitam putih karena ger sih. Sekarang baru kayak nge-explore gitu.
It's so good now.
Dan gimana tuh setelah kayak udah bereksplorasi dengan warna-warna, apakah merasa jadi kayak menemukan oh ini lebih cocok sama gue atau kayak lebih hitam putih lebih gue banget?
Ya, tergantung mood sih. Maksudnya bener, misalkan kayak tema talk ini kan kayak anger gitu kan. Tapi misalkan sometimes when I'm in a bad mood, gue tuh malas pakai warna because I feel like it kayak nggak bisa anyway, kayak nggak mampu gitu. Jadi kalau misalnya when I'm in a bad mood, it's probably only in black and white and super dark temanya. Yes, jadi kayak gitu. Kalau misal warna, I'm probably in a good mood and I started painting at like 10 in the morning gitu loh. Jadi kayak
wow.
Yeah, when I wake up, I guess 10.
Jadi
11.
Kayak baru bangun kayak langsung gambar gitu.
Mundur terus.
Kayak good mood tapi sampai kayak warna-warna. Wow.
Yeah. Dan gue tuh baru mulai pakai gouache. Ngomongin gouache.
Yeah.
Terus kayak gue beli gouache bagus banget, bikin gue jadi nafsu banget gitu loh gambar gara-gara it's like hasilnya bagus banget gitu. Dan gue sebelumnya kayaknya nggak pernah pakai paint sebagus itu, that's why kayak gue.
Miss Dana belum pernah sih nyoba pakai gouache, kayak opak banget gitu nggak sih?
Iya, itu kan kayak watercolor tapi kayak akrilik.
Jadi bingung harusnya itu kayak where do we have to place ourselves gitu sih, kayak kita nge-treat mereka sebagai
kayak akrilik sih menurut gue. Menurut gue mirip banget sama akrilik, but it's just like
lebih water based.
Jadi enggak sayang gitu, akrilik kan suka sayang kalau pakai lagi tuh kayak kalau gouache kayak ya udah kering semalaman, besok lo pakai lagi masih bisa gitu. Tuh. Cuman ya lo harus pakai kertas yang bagus, kalau enggak lo get fucked man. Jadi gitu. Terus sekarang
sekian gram.
In terms of a inspiration, I guess.
Yeah.
For drawing, I think it's a aduh siapa sih namanya, Otomo Katsuhiro
Otomo. Otomo siapa itu, boleh disebut? Otomo siapa tahu bisa di share share juga.
Domo.
Oh yeah.
Mike Mignola, which is a Hellboy. He does a lot of illustrations. Ula showed me Klimt back in the day. Dan jujur kayak cara gambar shadingnya dan figurnya lumayan nempel sih sampai sekarang, nggak tahu kenapa.
Lumayan nempel.
Lumayan sama Mobius, I guess the French.
Ya itu wah. Aku setuju.
I guess the occult.
Tapi siapa gitu?
No, I mean like basically the things surrounding the occult.
Yeah, I mean,
we start kayak gambar at the time where we listen to some harder music.
Well, I used to listen to death metal.
No, I was like, don't say that. Tapi maksudnya kayak I was into.
Mikrofagis ya, itu pecah banget sih.
Tadi apa aja Riem sini mau gue share?
Mikrofagis.
Anyway, gara-gara itu juga sih kayak occult stuff lame sih, but it's true.
I guess
that's mostly it.
Yeah, we kind of like shared a lot of interests in that realm juga. I mean, hitungannya juga HP Lovecraft gitu kan, kita juga
demen
juga kan.
And a lot of mythology at the time.
That's your thing.
Mythology was my thing.
Kok begini kotak? Kenapa kotak begini?
Eh, jangan marah dong.
Ini bertanya-tanya. Ups, ketahuan. Aduh.
Rahasia dapur.
Ya, jadi ini salah satu inspirasinya Karim nih ya. Cantik ya.
Yeah, really.
Sama
ini sih, I guess yang sampai sekarang masih agak nemplok tuh, there's this art movement called Art Brut,
yeah.
Yeah, it's outsider art, yeah, I guess. It translates to outsider art. And just really nice. Kayak yang gambar-gambar ilustrasi yang kayak Henry Darger.
Yeah. Tapi kayak secara literal tuh Brut artinya tuh raw sih. Jadi ini kayak...
Raw, yeah.
Basically, kita ngelihat gambar-gambar yang sangat raw gitu.
What's that short man?
Tuh, qu'est-ce que c'est l'art brut?
Wes. Mantul.
Ya udah, pokoknya begitu ya guys. Sekilas. Aduh, maaf banget ya guys, tadi ada bocoran.
Art Brut band.
Ya, itu juga ada bandnya.
It's really bad.
Terus.
Tadi untuk Karim lagi, tadi lupa nanya juga gimana ada apa perkembangan soal Yosugi, Bapak, Bab, dan artworknya gimana John Devoix,
It's
Devoid actually.
Devoid, okay. John Devoid.
It's very John Voight.
John Voight is John bapaknya Angelina Jolie. Sorry.
I don't know. I mean like I think gue cukup beruntung untuk bisa terus bereksperimen dan melakukan hal-hal aneh secara musik while, you know, still keeping the kind of a day job, I guess, yeah, as a music producer, freelance music producing gitu. Mm. I guess I'm just trying to keep that balance aja between like business and
pleasure.
I hate using
that. Pleasure.
Yeah, so yeah, mungkin secara visual, I've always wanted to just do my own art. Cuman setelah dipikir-pikir, gue tuh orangnya perfeksionis banget kalau masalah seni sendiri dan kayak ujung-ujungnya I always ruin the design because I just keep improving it or deproving it.
Harus di save dulu.
Beda loh.
Baru tambahin layer.
For me, it's not a non-linear thing gitu loh.
Well, that's just to be safe, I guess.
I guess. Cuman kayak once I changed it, I can't really see the previous one anymore juga gitu loh. For some reason, makanya setelah the first EP waktu yang ngerjain Monkshood itu gue komisi sama collage artist dari US.
Oh ya? Siapa? Yeah. Kalau boleh tahu.
Cursed Wheel.
Nama Instagramnya.
Iya, yeah, nama Instagramnya Cursed Wheel. Roda terkutuk. Yeah, I'm not super interested.
Terus so gimana tuh? Gimana awalnya bisa di approach bareng?
Melihatnya di eksplor sih kayak emang so for the longest time like the Los Angeles beat scene and rap scene tuh yang underground they always use like collages for their artwork. Kayak misalkan kalau kalian cari artis
kita pakai laptop nyokap kita, wait. So wait, how is it? How do you do it?
Just a double tap, and like click on it.
Sorry guys. There you go.
Ini si collage, si collage artisnya. Gimana Rim, lanjut?
Yeah, nah waktu itu tuh. Zaman-zaman itu kayak musisi-musisi kayak Mind Design, Knowledge, terus kayak Zero, itu tuh artworknya tuh selalu pakai collage. Jadi kayak pingin banget bisa kayak dapet vibe itu juga gitu loh di album Monkshood. Jadi kebetulan waktu nemu dia di Explore, langsung gue kontak aja.
Oh wow. Terus langsung kayak udah balas-balasan aja kayak oke kita collab bareng.
Nah, awalnya tuh dia udah buat dua collage untuk gua. Cuman tau-taunya dia yang kayak ini by the way ini arsip gua nih. Ini hal-hal yang ini collage-collage yang belum pernah dirilis. Terus
jadi ready stock gitu ya.
Akhirnya I wasn't expecting getting like maksudnya
tidak udah ada gitu
bisa nemu yang gue suka.
But his stuff is like
it's really punky.
Yeah, like as compared to your album, I think this one is a bit political.
Oh, he's right.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, tapi yang di archive itu tuh banyak yang kayak just random stuff gitu, just him making it in his free time kayaknya. Terus I found this one with the eclipse and like.
Jadi itu tuh bukan dari brief kamu. Yeah. Damn, that's
tapi bisa banget ya pas langsung kayak gue suka ini.
Yeah. Cuma I guess I have this strategy like when I'm trying to make or find an artwork for my music, ya udah gue setel musiknya sambil gue nge-scroll gitu loh. When a particular picture kind of like sets the mood, it's
yeah,
itu.
Terus kalau gitu ada kepikiran pengen collab gitu nggak selain sama yang seniman tadi untuk kedepannya kayak
Well, I am working with someone else for the next Bapak album. Kayak gue mau coba kayak lebih kerja sama orang-orang Indo, mungkin ya bisa dibilang kayak I don't know if I'm right or wrong, tapi kemarin yang EP yang Yosugi sama Greybox itu, I think the motherfucker was half Indo. I think.
Okay.
Because I looked at his mom and like, damn, that's like. But yeah,
she could just be like
just like super assumptions
South
aja.
South gitu. Asian or something, you know that.
Dan untuk yang bapak record ini udah artworknya udah jadi juga dan gue komisinya dari seniman Indo, pretty cool.
Nice.
Gitu deh, so hopefully it goes well.
Kalau selain kayak orang beneran, bukan orang beneran, tapi kayak kolabor itu bisa jadi kayak siapapun gitu loh, kayak mimpi kayak bisa aja sama brand atau sama apa gitu, pengennya sama siapa? Ula juga.
Untuk apa ya? Gue narsis sih, gue pengen difoto sama fotografer.
Brandnya suka foto?
Tuh, iya makanya. Brandnya deh kalau berhasil sama brandnya. Wait, I wanna check if the guy's still alive or not.
Eh, BTW, brandnya sekalian baca komen-komen YouTube ya?
Iya. Yeah. Oh, Araki masih hidup ya? Gue mau difoto sama Araki sih. Ooh, this is a lot of like collaborating.
Wah.
I think he would be.
Ada yang nanya kakak ada yang mana ya? Hah?
Itu Ichi anjir yang ngomong, dia udah tahu.
Oh. Ichi. Oh, gue kira Ichi.
No, this is the bigger sister I am.
Oh.
Sama Araki doang. Kalau gambar.
Oh iya, aku lupa. Bukan lanjutin lagi. Gambar ya. Maksudnya gimana?
Harus gambar misalkan kayak kemarin kan. Kemarin Ula kolaborasi sama Fatherland, udah tuh accomplish. Sekarang Ula pengen kolaborasi, oke.
Kita pindah bentar ya, cause we're at our mom's room.
Oke.
Okay. Bentar ya, kayak gimana kita bisa ngelatiin camera dulu lah?
No.
Are you serious?
Di mute atau ya, cerah?
Atau baterainya masih ada nggak?
Baterainya masih ada. Nggak ya, sorry banget.
Wow, rumah Ula, rumah Karim.
Jadi kayak
MPG hey, rumah gue.
Mom, you can come. Sorry, but sini aja kamar gue aja deh. Yang lain dulu aja hasilnya. Oke, kita pindah kamar gue. I'm so sorry. Kan kita grab a like. Ya.
Oke.
Wah, berantakan banget.
Tadi alat-alat gambarnya sudah dibawa?
Sudah.
Ini kok ada gambarnya?
Ya, internetnya tetap jalan ya?
Aduh.
Ya, jadi tadi sudah terjawab atau belum pertanyaannya Ula? Kayaknya belum ya?
Enggak. Apa tadi pertanyaan? Oh, kolaborasi ya? Gue pengen kolaborasi sama... Kalau gue pengen bikin komik sih. Kayak komik.
Oh, that'll be cool.
Terus kolaborasinya sama director film gitu. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It would be cool. You guys can guess it's probably David Lynch. Tapi kayak...
Oh,
yeah. Karena kayak... Can you imagine ceritanya dia dijadiin kayak komik? It would be like really cool, really dark, kayak noir gitu loh, kayak Sin City itu kan noir banget kan komiknya, kayak aesthetics-nya Sin City, tapi ceritanya David Lynch, keren banget sih.
Wow,
right?
Wow.
I would
actually imagine that though.
Yeah, it would work honestly. Yeah,
it would totally work.
Totally
get multiple. Yeah, any of his movies or a new movie, like an unreleased script.
I see.
Hmm. Jadi Karim nggak ada dreamnya?
Maybe I've always wanted to compose for a movie sih sebenarnya.
Yeah,
tapi kayak, this idea have not aged well. I really wanted to compose for Woody Allen sebenarnya. Jadi,
wah, nggak, sumpah Miss Brenda nggak expect sih Woody Allen.
Karim Woody Allen banget.
Oh wow, never expect that before.
Really? Oh, nobody knows himself.
Gak kelihatan sih. Maybe because of your cancer side.
Oh.
I mean, I guess besides that, kayak always wanted my music itu artworknya dari ya yang tadi-tadi sih sebenarnya juga kayak Mobius gitu. Cuman for some reason ingin banget digambarin Shintaro Kago sebenarnya sih.
I think you can still do that.
Gue pernah lihat itu.
Proactive on Instagram.
Honestly, man, iya kan kemarin yang album Flying Lotus yang kedua terakhir itu tuh You're
I
Dead.
I don't like that.
Ih, kenapa?
It's really good. I don't know.
It's so good.
I'm
breaking character.
I'm not a huge fan of Shintaro Kago.
Oh, I see.
I'm not a huge fan of Shintaro Kago. Like I'm okay about it, kayak biasa aja. And I think the coloring is a bit rough.
Yeah.
The coloring on that album is a bit rough. Kayak beneran inking, waktu di scan, waktu diwarnain pake Photoshop gitu sama dia.
Cuman yang aku gak suka tuh, emang di, if I had to say something that I didn't like about the album art, emang shadingnya tuh norak.
Shadingnya
norak. Oh, dia kayak, kalau terus aja tuh sebenernya bagus banget.
Jadi dikritik.
Capek,
lanjut. Nggak, bagus, harus kayak gitu. Harus kritis. Mending sekarang kita sekalian ngobrol-ngobrol sambil udah mulai gambar kali ya, biar waktunya cukup. Oke, jadi kalian yang lagi nonton, hari ini task-nya adalah untuk gambar melalui emosi kita. Hah, gimana ya? Gimana sih ngomongnya? Emosi ditaruh ke kertas, ya gitu. Semacam seperti itu. Jadi misalkan kemarin kalian ingat kalau kalian lagi sedih, terus kalian kayak coba gambarin itu, tapi kenapa? Tapi kayak gak harus dari emosi-emosi yang kayak depresif banget atau apa. Bisa juga kayak misalkan kalian ketinggalan antar jemput, atau ketinggalan dompet, atau misalkan makanan kalian dimakan sama adik kakak kalian, terus kalian kayak bete banget, kayak coba gambarin dalam kertas ini aja, biar kita perlahan-lahan mencoba untuk mencurahkan hati kita dan juga untuk lebih ekspresif.
Okay.
Begins.
I was thinking like drawing head yang kayak this guy just looking confused, tapi he's just grabbing onto his head too tight, and then the head starts melting into his arm.
Okay.
Sounds kind of nice.
Kayak dijambak gitu.
Apa?
Kayak dijambak gitu.
Ya, dijambak kayak di kayak
ditarik.
Digencet gitu kali.
Digenggam.
Yeah, I guess that's the right word.
Mulai gambar, semua gambar ya. Jadi kalau misalkan udah selesai gambar, di tag ke Tiny, di story atau di upload foto, terserah kalian seenaknya. Kalau misalkan kalian mau ngasih tahu Miss Brenda doang untuk dinilai dan bilang nggak usah dipublikasiin Miss, aku takut, aku malu, nggak apa-apa, chat aja kayak gitu. Ntar Miss Brenda nggak publikasiin.
Miss Brenda,
our savior.
Atau ibu Brenda. Ula, mau nanya dong. Gimana sih? Gimana sih?
Gimana?
Aduh. Ini mejanya, meja gue tuh bawahnya ditambahin buku gitu biar tinggi soalnya. Jatuh-jatuh mulu. Oke, tadi apa ya, La? Gue mau nanya apa ya?
Ayo.
Lo gimana awalnya kayak gambar gimana ya, bukan beep. Aduh, lagi bingung mau gambar apa dan lagi bingung mau nanya apa, jadi bingung banget. Harus yang mana dulu yang dilakuin ya?
Rahasia dapur, bukan rahasia dapur.
Oke, jadi deh kalau gitu ntar aja pertanyaan itu. bingung banget nggak bisa. Untuk kalian berdua deh pertanyaannya.
Kenapa?
What makes y'all angry?
Just life in general.
I'm angry because people are still pulang kampung, bitch.
Yeah. Banyak lihat di Instagram masih kayak gitu, eh.
Iya, yeah, gue jadi pengen keluar, anjir.
Jangan jadi kayak mereka lah, gimana deh?
Ya enggak, tapi maksudnya kayak, damn, kita PSBB.
Like, happy for nothing.
Enggak ketemu sama siapa, gila.
Terus, emang kalian udah gak keluar berapa lama?
Ya sebenarnya kita masih keluar dikit sih. Bawah ke bawah. Kan kita tinggal di apartemen.
Gue masih sepedaan sih setiap hari.
Kalau masih ke bawah doangnya gak apa-apa gak sih?
Gue sepedaan tapi sendiri biasanya.
Apa yang bikin marah lagi ya? Kabarin.
Karim atau Ula, kalian saling bikin marah satu sama lain atau gak pernah?
I mean, like, most of the time during quarantine, what makes me angry is just myself.
Oof.
I guess.
Sad boy.
Yeah, it's just the overthinking and like. So I think, yeah, I mean, like, when I have problems, you kind of depend on meeting your friends. It's like easier thoughts down and stuff. Cuman kayak this quarantine kind of pushes you to be in a corner and kind of face your insecurities and doubts. I mean, like, alhamdulillah aja maksudnya I have Ula to talk to.
Aww.
Alhamdulillah. Never forget to thank the Lord.
Oh my God. Just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Tapi bukan yang kayak kalau misalkan tadi lo bilang gara-gara karantin jadi kayak susah untuk kayak nge-overcome gitu segala macam. Tapi bukan dengan kayak ada isolasinya kayak gini jadi lebih bisa belajar sama diri sendiri, jadi bisa lebih nge-handle diri sendiri atau apa gitu.
Alhamdulillah lumayan sih kayak lebih self-aware sih ya sekarang jadinya kayak okay, I think I'm having an episode atau kayak I think the bad mood is coming gitu, what should I do, kayak lebih preventif gitu sih sekarang, which is kind of good I guess. Cuman kayak sometimes you kind of wish you didn't feel like this in the first place.
Iya, ya tapi kan kita juga nggak bisa menolak itu sih. It's nature.
Technical.
Terus.
Maaf ya, Miss Benda lagi mikir, bingung banget Miss Benda.
Benda!
Aduh, Miss Benda tuh orangnya pelupa gitu, ayang soalnya. Kalau misalkan audience masih bingung, chat aja ya langsung soal tes gambarnya gimana. Tapi Miss Brenda mau jelasin kalau misalkan kita literally di sini bisa gambar apa aja, gambar self portrait kalian, gambar presentasi kalian jadi sesuatu objek atau apapun, kayak bisa sebebas apapun, kayak just be wild with your thoughts. I hope bisa juga ceritain sharing dikit lewat story kalau mau. Oke. Okay. Semoga itu sudah jelas. Kalian udah mulai gambar ya?
Udah dong.
Nah, gimana emang mulai dari tadi?
Miss Brenda kosong.
Miss Brenda.
Bingung gitu harus milih warna apa ya? Ya Allah.
Thank you, imaginary voice.
Kayak sebenarnya bisa ini sih latihan bikin ekspresi gitu. Ada masukan untuk penonton-penonton. Anjing. Bisa gini deh. Misalkan ini lo pakai Stabilo gitu. Or whatever you want. Bisa aja Stabilo pink deh yang lucu. Jadi kayak lo bikin bundaran gini. Terus kayak bundaran gini nih. Tapi lo bikin banyak. Misalkan ada 10 gitu. Terus dari 10 ini lo gambarin kayak ekspresi-ekspresi beda gitu. Misalkan dan ini angry, ini sad, ini disappointed, ini in love gitu. Atau apa gitu.
Dan ekspresi-ekspresinya juga kalian bisa invent sendiri juga. Kayak misalkan kalian bilang, duh ini ekspresi kalau orang lagi boker gitu juga boleh. Atau kayak ekspresi kelindes bajai gitu juga gak apa-apa.
You do look like a cone.
Terus kalian ngerasa kalau anger itu sahabat kalian tuh bukan teman, sahabat atau kayak justru musuh? Atau kalian kayak bisa sums up ini semua as if like more negative than a positive thing to feel?
Kalau lo tanya ke Rio pasti Rio bilang marah.
Gak ada yang tau Rio di sini Ula.
Rio itu pacarnya Ula ya, orang-orang. Orang-orang.
Tapi kan you know what they say, what's bad for the heart is good for the art.
Yeah.
No, but it's true.
Yeah, I hate that. Because it's
lame because like people use it as their bio, but like other than that,
really?
It's pretty true. I think so. Yeah.
Orang pakai itu di bio-nya emang.
I think so. I've seen one. Okay, I'm sorry if that person is watching or will see this. Tapi maksudnya, gue pernah lihat. Pokoknya deh, gue nggak tahu juga.
Ya doesn't mean orang itu nggak representasiin semuanya dan enggak gue nggak pernah bilang kalau itu tuh hal yang cheesy. No, it's true.
The quote is
sad, but it's true.
It's true, but it's not so easy to think.
Tapi dalam kalian sendiri gimana?
I think I hate to admit it, but you know I do depend on being internally angry to feel some type of way sometimes. I don't know. Sometimes, you know that feeling when you go outside and the weather is good, but you're kind of like, why is the weather good? You get along.
Why?
And then you don't appreciate the weather at all because you're just thinking.
Demi Allah, kayak Anda jadi pengen nge-share sesuatu. Kayak kalau misalkan Miss Brenda kayak lagi feeling blue gitu ya, terus. Tapi di luar tuh cuacanya kayak sangat cerah dan kayak cuacanya tuh nge-force Miss Brenda untuk kayak ayo lo gak boleh sedih-sedih, lo harus semangat. Tapi kayak gue nyalahin cuacanya kayak kenapa sih harus cerah, kenapa gak mendung aja, ngerti gak sih?
Yeah,
it's kind of like that feeling, kayak it's like a sort of skepticism to the feeling of joy.
Demi Allah.
And then like you kind of spend the whole day like waiting until the weather gets shitty, but then it's already nighttime.
Yes.
And like you wasted the whole day not enjoying the perfect weather because something bad.
Yes.
If I can put it in that way.
Itu adalah perasaan Miss Brenda yang kayak Miss Brenda selalu keep sendiri gitu sih, dan kayak bersyukur banget Karim bisa ngerepresentasi dan bisa ngomong itu juga ke audience. Thank you Karim.
Thank you Karim.
Baca-baca komen itu.
Looks like an Iceland lizard. Iceland lizard.
Mana sih?
Probably not. They have no sun.
Apa itu Iceland lizard? It's so magical. Oh wow.
Brenda, I'm full of rage.
Thank you.
Brenda,
I don't know.
That sounds like a 2000s alternative song.
Miss Brenda!
Kayak Fountains, enggak, aku bayangin kayak Fountains of Wayne gitu loh. Or is that not alternative? Is it just called like rock?
I think so.
Maaf ya Miss Brenda, aduh belum mulai gambar. Kalian udah gambar apa aja?
I'm only drawing one big piece, I guess.
Nih, lihat mau gambar, mau lihat gambar Miss Brenda nggak?
Lihat dong, Miss Brenda. Apa? Gak kelihatan anjir?
Kosong. Nol. Mulai.
Aku gambarnya lagi gambar.
Pulse.
I like the sass.
Apa?
Dari ilustrasi lo gitu, itu kan kayak 90% atau mungkin 100% perempuan semua ya. Itu ada hubungannya kah dengan feminisme atau kayak gimana lo suka gambar perempuan karena lo perempuan aja atau kayak
sebenarnya mungkin ada ya kaitannya dengan feminisme karena biasanya yang gue gambar cewek telanjang semua. Dan maksudnya gue selalu pengen menormalisasikan tubuh perempuan sih, jadi kayak nggak sepenuhnya kalau misalnya gue gambar cewek telanjang itu berarti kayak wah ini bokep gitu, atau gue bikin komik yang tentang tema-tema erotika tuh bukan artinya kayak itu bokep gitu. Maksudnya kan kita tinggal di Indonesia ya, jadi kayak hal-hal ini sebenarnya tabu, masih tabu gitu. Dan dari dulu nyokap gue aja masih nanya gitu, kayak misalnya gue gambar dua cewek telanjang ya gue dianggap gitu, apa rambut gini. That's not it at all, gitu ya sih, kayak because it's the only thing that relates to me the most gitu kan, yang gue mandi,
yang
ngeliat diri sendiri. And I think the female body is the most beautiful thing ever, jadi kayak yaudah, gue cuma pengen menormalisasikan aja sih. Dan kalau misalnya orang masih mikir kayak ini orang gambar bokep terus gitu, ya that's not the point man, berarti lo yang harus gotta fix your head gitu.
Berarti kayak goalnya emang lebih untuk menormalisasikan gitu.
Ya, dan sebenarnya kayak itu lumayan fluid sih buat gue untuk gambar cewek telanjang, kayak gue jarang banget pakein baju gitu, nggak tau kenapa.
Udah second nature aja sih.
Udah kayak langsung zeng gitu aja. Jadi kayak sebenarnya awalnya mungkin nggak mikir ya, tapi lama-lama setelah gue denger kayak pendapat orang tentang itu, gue jadi mikir kayak ya udah gue I don't want to stop doing this just because people think it, what do you call it?
Taboo.
Bold. Yeah.
Transgressive.
No, it's not transgressive. Like, it's not completely transgressive. Cuman, ya gitu. Cuma mau biar orang biasa aja gitu. Sampai orang biasa baru gue sukses berarti.
Amin. Amin.
Janjir.
Kalau kalian ya.
God lives in Bimbar.
Enggak, Ciputat bro.
Oh, God lives in Ciputat. God lives. He has a piercing.
Ada suara apa itu?
Aku berjanjar.
Nama rumahnya itu namanya terus
duh
Brenda udah gambar sama mana? Oh miss
belum
gambar dong,
kan ngajak ngobrol ya susah gila nggak apa sambil gambar
apa aja.
Kan masalahnya Miss Brenda yang kayak nanya-nanya, dan kalau nanya-nanya tuh kayak begitu.
Gimana
brand? Apanya?
Keadaan.
Ini sih kemarin hari Senin kita udah stop lockdown.
Wow, really?
Ya, tapi walaupun kayak toko apa segala macam belum pada buka banget, kita kayak udah mencoba untuk menormalisasikan virus dan kayak terima aja apa adanya.
Maksudnya gimana menormalisasikan virus?
Jadi nunggu imunitas lo ngebantu gitu maksudnya?
Iya, jadi kan soalnya ada kayak apa namanya, ada kayak beberapa dokter gitu loh yang kayak against the isolation, gara-gara ini tuh akan kayak justru ngubah imunitas kita jadi rendah gitu, dan kayak kita tuh udah gak bisa apa-apa lagi sama corona, jadi kayak mau gak mau kita udah harus terima aja. Jadi kayak dengan cara terima aja, ya udah kita gak usah lockdown lagi. Kalau misalkan orang kena sakit, ya udah orang kena sakit, tapi kita gak bisa ngapa-ngapain tuh.
Ya yeah.
Just die gitu.
Gak juga sih.
Gak juga apanya?
Maksudnya gak just die. Tadi kalian bilang just die.
Oh. Iya. Tapi kayak sekarang juga maksudnya kalau pergi tuh juga nggak boleh lebih dari grup berbanyak-banyak orang.
Nggak
gitu.
Bisa lebih dari 10 gitu.
Lebih dari 5 sih.
Anjir, nggak ada party.
Nggak ada sih, belum ada sih kayaknya party-party itu ya.
Kalau ada kan udah kelihatan di story Nadine tuh bos.
Tapi
di story Nadine bukan Brenda.
Kemarin gue liat di Korea, mereka baru buka. Terus habis itu udah ada yang bikin party.
Oh, mereka juga udah gak karantin lagi?
Zero, patient zero, satu orang. Dia spread ke semua bar. One person.
Apa-apa lah, ulang gak denger.
Kayak, jadi di gue lupa di Korea atau di Cina, gue lupa deh. Pokoknya mereka baru buka lockdownnya, jadi orang pada party lah gitu. Jadi udah pada sehat semua, tapi ada satu orang yang sakit. Nah, orang itu nyebarin dari bar ke bar, jadi kayak jadi dari satu bar ini dia pindah ke bar satu lagi, pindah ke bar satu lagi, jadi dia kayak bar hopping without knowing that he's sick gitu.
Oh wow.
Terus dia jadi patient zero, jadi kayak semua orang kenal lagi dari dia. Gitu.
Demi apa?
Oh, namanya tuh patient zero.
Ya kalau misalnya di zombie gitu kan kayak patient zero tuh orang yang pertama nyebarin gitu.
Iya. Yeah.
You're welcome. The more you know. Aduh, gambarku jelek.
Sama dong. Tapi nggak apa-apa.
Ancur
bagus
banget.
Kok lucu. Bilanya. Tunjukin lebih dekat lah. Marah.
Dulu kita art class kayak gini nggak sih di hari Prana? Enggak.
Aduh, ya Allah. Kecoret lagi. Enggak. Dulu kita basically gambar apa aja sih, tapi kayak Miss Ria tuh orang yang sangat baik. Dia rela untuk gambarin orang-orang sebelum dicat gitu loh. Ingat enggak?
Apa?
Jadi dia tuh kayak rela untuk gambarin murid-muridnya dulu gambarnya gimana, baru mereka yang ngechat.
Si orang itu. Siapa namanya?
Miss Rianya, orang itu.
Ih, gue lupa. Tapi gue gak pernah ngikutin dia suruh gue gambar apa sih.
Emang kita gak pernah disuruh, tapi kayak kita dikasih buku gitu loh, paling kayak katalog museum apa gitu. Terus kayak, oh ya ngikutin gambarnya Avandi atau apa, kayak gitu sih.
Iya.
Cool.
Tapi kayak dulu gue biasanya kayak ngikutin katalog-katalog gambar kayak Polly Pocket gitu.
Oh, gue bawa tempat les. Kita dikasih katalog gue.
Ya kan?
Gue belanja terus sih di hari Prana, gila.
Mahal banget sih. Ya.
Mahal gitu. Beneran.
Yang enggak tahu hari Prana itu apa, itu adalah art gallery yang terletak di Kemang, dan mereka juga buka art classes. Ada gambar, ada ngelukis, ada art attack, tapi enggak tahu sih sekarang
masih ada apa enggak.
Art Attack gak tau, wah seru banget, aduh apa seru itu? Banget. Lo tau Art Attack kan tapi?
Iya tau lah. Yang,
yaudah.
Yang di Nickelodeon.
Nickelodeon
sih. Sorry.
Abis itu yaudah, kayak kita sama Miss Ria juga sih, itu literally ngelakuin ya Art Attack gitu, kayak acara Art Attack, tapi Art Attack gitu loh.
Gue gak pernah sih, berarti.
Seru banget. Terus kalian dengan kayak mengikuti kelas Miss Brenda yang ini, kalian sendiri juga sama ini menggambar melalui emosi kalian atau kayak gambar untuk kayak udah gambar aja?
I think when it comes to making art, I guess there's always a purpose. Gitu loh.
Yeah.
And no matter how mundane or like serious it is, I think you kind of draw or like make music to heal
something. Yeah.
Kayak whether it's boredom or your sadness or just rage in general. Cuman I do draw most of the time for the fuck of it. I guess. It used to be very therapeutic back in high school. Kayak this is a weird thing. Cuman gue tuh orangnya enggak suka berantem ya. Jujur. Dan gue gak suka marah-marah.
Pasifis, Karim pasifis.
Iya, tapi the only time I pick fights is when people disturb me while I draw.
Asik.
Gak asik sama sekali sih.
Asik. Yeah, but I know, I get it.
Tapi it kind of like taught me to like improvise and draw without a plan in mind. Soalnya kayak kalau gambar terus totek senggol atau apa, kan totek kayak gambarnya agak kecoret.
Yeah.
And then you kind of have to like, oh shit, okay, what do I do now?
Sorry. Sedih apaan sih pertanyaannya ya? Oh iya. Gimana ya, terus?
Kocak deh lagi nih.
Ya gimana lagi gambar susah banget lo mikir. Diketawainnya parah banget.
Your idea, this is the whole concept of your like podcast.
Riem belum selesai.
Oh, okay.
Mending baca komen dulu deh biar kembali lagi memori.
Komennya apa tuh?
Kakak, ade nggak boleh satu tongkrongan, gitu katanya. Mau bikin girl in purple hat tapi cannot draw that with rage. Eriza Hasam. Mau bikin apa? Ya udah, nggak usah pakai itu.
Yang fans ke fans sama Nadine gitu.
Enggak sih, ini yang ngomong pacara kakak gue loh.
Oh.
Biasanya Kak Ula dan Kak Karim kalau lagi marah terus gambar itu gambarin penyebabnya, current self situation atau sesuatu yang kalian harapkan atau idealnya. Atau asal aja yang penting energinya lepas.
Itu sih lebih the latter kalau gue. I rather take where my head sees fit. Cuman I do write as well biasanya. So biasanya I draw and then somewhere on the sides or in the top I write something and I don't think about it gitu. I just let my mind kind of write itself down to paper and usually it's like so depressing. Cuman it kind of helps sih. It helps like I feel like you know, I really like Converge Gun, the band Gun. Terus the vocalist tuh a visual artist juga.
Yeah, covernya yang buat dia.
Yeah, all of it most of the time. Terus waktu itu aku baca interview dia, terus kayak ini musik lu ini negatif banget. But it seems that you are a very hopeful person. Kayak how does that actually work gitu loh. Terus dia yang kayak ya sebenarnya I let my music do the negative talking because I do depend on my music. Untuk kayak gue bisa ngekeluarinnya tuh semua di situ gitu loh. So all the ugly stuff in my head, I just channel it through the music so that I can live with a better mindset. Through the day. And like that really kind of like resonated with me. I just see that sentence, that whole paragraph gitu, and that's what I've been trying to do ever since. So
terus
like when you hear my
album,
I feel like berhasil. In a weird way, kayak all the problems and all the turmoil that I talk about di lagu-lagu gue, it
it just stays there. It stays in the song. It's like a Pokeball, gitu. It kind of catches the mood, mm-hmm. and it just keeps it in the song, and I don't feel it anymore.
But that's not completely true. The fact that the feeling goes away after you put it down, right?
Tapi for like the first EP, Belladonna, it really went like that for some reason. I think it's because okay, it's out in the world. Ini udah rilis. I cannot take it back. I cannot take anything that I said back. Gitu. Mm-hmm. This is like 100% my honest opinion about my life and my struggles. Yeah, udah. And I kind of felt good, like just throwing that all away. Gitu, you know.
Jadi yang kayak tadi Karim bilang aja ini sebagai ini sebagai hal yang therapeutic gitu kan.
Mm-hmm.
Tapi kadang Miss Brenda tuh juga suka kayak mencoba untuk melakukan itu, tetapi kadang saking bingungnya bikin apa, jadi kayak ya udah stuck, terus udah kayak justru jadi marahnya tuh di situ enggak ngapa-ngapain, ngerti enggak sih?
Yeah. I mean, like, Ula can vouch for me when I say I kind of depend on being productive juga gitu loh, and it's getting to a very unhealthy place juga, because like I feel like anything is an escape at this point, and you can like lo bisa membohongi diri sendiri dan bilang kayak produktivitas lo tuh berhasil positif gitu, but at the end of the day it's just like an escape aja juga.
It's a nice escape. Yeah. I mean, better than like doing drugs or having sex with running, running away from home.
I don't do home.
I'm just saying maybe that's what other people do. We're talking to a lot of people.
I guess so.
Jadi kalau kalian marah, gambar aja atau bikin musik aja atau joget aja atau Joget enak banget sih.
Some people love doing that. Kayak my neighbor, who is also my best friend. Dia kayak, kalau lagi frustrated, dia nari sendiri di kamar dan lama banget. Gue kayak, I can't do that, obviously. But like, I admire people who could.
Yeah.
I really could. Like, that's really incredible. Okay. I feel like someone who's always watching. Jadi kayak mau.
Iya, kerasa sih tahu.
Brenda, Yudha tuh nari-nariin.
Tante Brenda nari. Tante Brenda personal.
Tante, ibu, miss, Jen. Yang mana nih?
I think I'm done.
Tante Brenda, kenapa jadi tante? Sebel.
Adam.
Apa gue gambar itu?
I think I'm done, no I'm not.
I'm not done.
Jangan selesai lah. Kita punya ada waktu berapa lagi sih? Ih ya Allah, Ibun ngomong kayak gitu aja nggak bisa. Kita ada berapa waktu? Kita punya berapa waktu lagi sih?
Wow. Gila, men.
Baik nanya nih.
41 people literally watched us look our head down the drawing.
Oh my God, I love you guys.
Wow. Ini gue mau bacain ya. So you that kind of kid who the revolutioners secretly recruit from school to predict the Armageddon.
Did you ever talk about that?
I think our persona. But no, I mean like, I think the revolutionaries. More revolutionaries.
What? I would love to. Oh no. Drawing is pretty intense. You can communicate better with special people who like normal communication method, even way more clear by visual stimulation. Shout out to illegal mural artists. Okay. Yep. Did you know Banksy? Itu siapa?
Itu ini ya
maksud
itu siapa? Kan kayak udah agak terkuak-terkuak.
Beneran-beneran ya sih anggotanya?
I don't think so. It's just a hoax, man.
Dude, tapi it totally makes sense if it is him. Like, it kind of makes sense. Kayak orang bikin
No.
Nah, ini udah habis. Maybe it's in mom's room.
I'll be right back.
Yeah. Gimana lah?
Apa? Oh ya, Banksy gosipnya itu personilnya masih betek gosipnya.
Oh.
Terus lo ada yang kayak skema lokasinya Banksy sama terus sama si Robert Del Naha. Jadi kayak dan Robert Del Naha kan juga kayak graphic artist ya. Jadi gue kayak anjir keren juga sih kalau misalnya because I'm not a huge fan of Banksy, cuman kayak kalau misalnya Robert Del Naha itu Banksy jadi kayak 10 times cooler.
Ya, yeah. Gue lagi nge-search sih. Ini kapan sih?
Oh, ada suara apa sih? Oh.
It's Science Massive with this organization. But, tapi kalau iya keren banget sih. Iya sih. Kalau iya.
Kalo tapi kan soalnya iya. Si Goldie keceplosan awalnya dari dia
lu ngomong apa?
Keceplosan gitu kayak Robert Goldie. Maksudnya pas lagi ditanya tentang Banksy tapi dia jawabnya pakai nama Robert kayak iya Robert kayak gue kayak well seru abis
seru banget jadi seorang misterius gitu kayak dulu gue juga pernah coba kayak graffiti gitu sama anak kampus. Tapi kayak aduh takut banget ujung-ujungnya kayak berisik apa kejar polisi.
Kalau di sini boleh aja main bombing.
Ini nggak boleh deh, mana-mana nggak boleh tau.
Masuk ke tempat lain.
Kayak di ini ya, di dinding panjang yang Citos itu hipnose
itu commission
kok. Itu kayak zaman masa kecil banget.
Terus kayak kalau ada yang baru kayak wow, that's you gitu.
Iya kayak wah beda nih sama
tapi juga. Sometimes you kinda like damn kok indi tabrak kayak yang bagus sih kesel gitu.
Itu kan darbots kan, nyonyon darbots kan.
Yeah, the granddaddy.
Terus ada mau nanya nih Brenda.
Ya.
Gitu. Bentar. kalian ada salah satu kayak in real life situation enggak yang kayak mempengaruhi karya kalian? Kayak satu particular moment atau kayak period of time yang kayak bikin kalian kayak progress banget soal kehidupan, soal berkarya kalian gitu.
I think going to Europe actually really kind of changed.
Really?
Yeah. Because for some reason, waktu... So we went on this Europe trip dulu sekeluarga. And like, I was on my heavy comic binge banget. And like, found this one random store that sells like... random comics gitu, and I just bought some. I bought The Authority, which is like a really good action comic. It's like a kick-ass, but more violent, and way more open-minded topics.
What do you mean, like?
Like the team too, there's like this hero named Midnighter. Terus ada satu lagi, Apollo.
Lu tau juga kali
dia? Apollo got the sun, mm-hmm. And they're like men and they're gay, gitu.
Oh.
And they're like married.
Where's that book now?
Oh, it's a comic, it's not a book.
Okay, where's the comic now?
Terus.
Yeah, and I think they kind of like painted the main like drawing style for me, I guess. Soalnya artis itu tuh siapa ya? Cuman kayak, I just kept thinking like, damn, this guy really draws well. Gitu lah, I want to be able to draw like this, gitu. And kind of, ya udah, kind of permeated until now.
Jadi setelah Europe trip itu, abis itu beli komik, abis itu kayak semenjak itu jadi kayak ngerubah, bukan ngerubah, tapi kayak influence karya lo.
Mm-hmm. And like, I kind of like, saw a lot of European comics juga and how their drawing style really are different gitu.
Kayak apa tuh European comic?
Kayak heavy metal, you know, the famous French comic magazine. Itu kan selalu beda-beda ilustratornya dan segala hal gitu. That's where I saw Mobius for the first time juga. I got in tune with his comics, kayak Arzark.
and like I don't know, maybe Inka, I think, and like his weirder stuff, you know. Sorry.
Jesus.
Kalau lo lah.
Apa ya? Sebenarnya, like, illustrating and drawing for me is like a hobby. Gue sih kayak, I really want to work in the art industry, tapi bukan sebagai pengkarya gitu. Ngerti? Yeah, I've always wanted to be like behind the scenes. Kayak, probably, yeah, the Europe trip was pretty great.
It was really good.
But then I went to Europe again with my aunt as a reward for doing well in school, and that was an art trip.
Apaan tuh art trip? Gimana jadinya?
No. Jadi gue, okay, I'm more fortunate than Karim in terms of travel.
Yeah, sure.
Gue kayak pas SMA, I went to New York, and then I also went to Paris when gue masuk kuliah. Karena pas saya masuk kuliah, I got good grades, and my aunt, itu kayak, she gave me a reward for doing well in school. Terus dia bawa gue pergi ke Paris for like, I think, a week or 2 weeks or something.
Banget.
Yeah, nah, abis itu di situ gue sebenarnya I didn't want to be an artist. Like I wanted to work with artists. Gue tuh kayak pengen jadi curator sih sebenarnya, or like a researcher or some sort, because I'm really into like classic art rather than conceptual. Sebenarnya kayak karena kan kayak there's so much to learn. Zaman dulu gitu loh kan, because yeah, it's the roots gitu loh, kayak apa yang lo lihat sekarang. I think conceptual art is quite interesting because it's so vast dan udah kayak ya anything could be art, right? Kayak tapi kan semuanya tuh ada awalnya, nah itu yang gue mau pelajari dari awalnya itu.
But I mean you're like still a fan of like Barbara Sutton stuff.
Sure, but it's not all conceptual artists. Ngerti gak sih kayak I've got a very particular taste gitu loh. Tapi kayak banyak yang udah sekarang yang udah kayak udah random aja gitu. Enggak ada idenya, ngerti sih idenya.
The
whole thing is just the idea. It's not like the presentation. Ngerti gak?
Jadi kayak lo lebih somehow mengapresiasikan presentasinya gitu.
Nggak juga, karena zaman sekarang kan nggak bisa kayak gitu. Zaman sekarang kan kayak, you have to look at the concept. Tapi kan zaman dulu kan nggak ada konsepnya, ngerti nggak sih? Kayak konsepnya tuh...
It
was just straight up craftsmanship from... Kayak, dan themes-nya tuh from something yang tangible banget gitu. Kalau sekarang kan... Sekarang tuh intangible, it's about like thoughts and opinions and like feelings gitu kan.
Whereas zaman dulu... Lebih kritis dong sekarang.
Iya, interesting. Cuman gue suka, gue mungkin dari awal sukanya classics ya. Kayak gue tuh paling suka movement neoklasikal. Karena itu kayak lo udah ngelewatin barok, terus rococo, terus abis itu masuk lagi ke zaman dulu lagi. Kayak they're trying to purify everything, and I think that's quite interesting in terms of like psychology kan.
Kayak, not racially.
What do you mean? Gak ada racially. It's obviously... kayak, there's nothing to do with that. Let's not make this political.
It's funny.
Maksudnya gitu, kayak kalau sekarang kan kayak intangible aja. Dulu pas lagi di pas lagi ke New York, abis itu pergi ke Paris, kayak lo ke Metropolitan, the Met, you go to the Met and you're like, oh my god, gitu. Ngerti gak sih kayak?
Aduh, pengen banget.
Tapi kan itu kan beda, kayak abis itu after you go to the Louvre. Dan apa sih namanya, ada satu lagi museum yang depannya M, apa namanya? No, di Prancis.
Depannya M, banyak. Yang semua ada, depannya M, museum, literally.
Itu kan yang ada statue-nya Albrecht Dürer yang ini. Like a rhino, man, I forgot what the name of the museum is.
You know this shit better.
Isinya apa?
Yang the origin of the world ada di situ, yang gambar meme.
Gue tahu lo taknya di mana, tapi gue lupa namanya apa.
Itu tau gue cari dulu, gue lupa banget sih namanya apa. Orsay.
I said that.
I didn't hear you say that.
I love that museum. That's my favorite museum ever.
Tapi itu like, di museum itu nggak ada tahu lukisannya Matisse atau Van Gogh.
Nggak ada, nggak tahu deh, gue nggak ingat. Cuma
nggak ada.
Kamu tuh lagi banyak orientalist art.
Oh.
Jadi kayak pas gue datang orientalist, and it's like it was the most interesting thing karena all these white people painting about like you know kayak culture-nya kita gitu basically kan, which is now like problematic right? Tapi at the time I was like wow it's very European dan lo bandingin sama cara gambar kita di sini gitu kayak
problematis.
It's so different. It's not problematic. It's part of history.
Problem.
Yeah.
Part of history. Ya sama aja kayak orang pada enggak kayak ada lukisan Balthus so they think it's like pedophilic gitu kan.
Yeah.
Terus mereka they want to remove it from the museum. And I'm like kalau gitu you gotta remove everyone else gitu kayak you have to remove Gauguin because he was a pedophile as well gitu ngerti gak sih ya?
Like,
you know what I mean? Yeah.
Kalau udah ngomong ke situ udah susah banget sih nggak. No.
But I feel like itu kan kayak it was the fault of the norm at that time in Singapore. Yeah. Tapi like I remember like I think it was Cartoon Network or like Disney. Mereka tuh they kind of showcase their old cartoons that were like very racist gitu.
Siapa?
Disney or Cartoon Network.
Oh yeah, Disney is like super racist.
Yeah, kayak animal stereotyping to like races gitu, kalau nggak salah. Nah, they kind of made it available to the world again via the internet. Tapi sebelumnya mereka tulis kayak this was the product of the time.
Aku tahu nama filmnya Song of the South. Song of the South.
Yeah.
That's the name
lupa
of the movie.
Lupa pokoknya. Tapi dia nulis itu kayak intinya, ini tuh produk pada zamannya dan walaupun emang buruk. Cuman kalau kita coba nutupin, that is like erasing a part of history gitu.
Iya,
yeah,
jadi art sih.
Apa sih penasaran deh?
Shape it gitu loh, because you're like looking through, you're going through a looking glass
into another world. And then you're thankful because it's not like that anymore.
Iya, tapi kayak when people try to like delete that and hide it, they're kind of like refusing to remember the history, I guess. Kayak untuk menerima mungkin ya.
Ya menerima, tapi sama kayak untuk kita lebih jadi belajar aja juga gitu loh. Kayak tapi never mind, Brenda nggak mau getting to political.
Yeah. This is about angers.
Ya, yeah. Ini soal perasaan.
Nggak usah kesana.
Balik lagi deh soal anger deh. Tanya mau lihat itu apa?
TikTok with that dance on that diva time. Maris always wanted to start an OnlyFans. Itu Megan Thee Stallion yang Beyonce remix.
Oh.
Bro, that song.
Iya kan aku udah dengar. Aku biasa aja. I'm sorry.
Kalau udah mau selesai belum?
Udah
ish.
Like 99%.
Gue belum tahu banget sih. Kalian gampang nggak tahu kalau misalkan karya kalian udah jadi atau belum? Ngerti nggak?
Enggak, thumbs up.
Kayak harus ngelanjutin lagi nggak ya? Atau kayak udah?
I think lama-kelamaan, I might just convert into the Church of Ula gitu, where I just draw everything as black and white. Color is such a drag, man. It's like black and white is just two different colors, gitu. Tapi kayak when you're adding like RGB or like CMYK, and then your head kind of fucking explodes aja gitu loh. Ujung-ujungnya kayak damn, warna ini enak sih sama warna ini.
Kan maksudnya di komputer.
Iya.
Aku tuh gak pernah loh pakai komputer buat warnain.
Kamu kan pure sama bagus kamu warnain.
Sama, lama. Masa sih? Belum pernah sekutu sama saya.
I hardly ever do it.
Don't you wanna try it? Don't you wanna try it?
I've tried it before. I don't like the way it looks. Kecuali gue punya Procreate. Anjir.
Kamu nabung kan?
Enggak, gue mau beli laptop baru aja anjir, gak penting. iPad.
Okay. No judgment, ya?
No, not at all. Kenapa sih Procreate gak bisa di MacBook? Rasis deh.
Anjing.
Just a joke. Apa lagi gambar gue yang gak jelas?
Same. Ada yang udah saya juga belum dari audience nih gambarnya? Tolong ya di tag ke Tiny Studio.
Tiny. Can someone be a bad absurdist opinion wise?
Gara-gara kepala.
Bang Karim ada niat nggak buat pakai Arthur Keula di album lu, Bang?
Yeah, actually, they didn't love this album, I suppose.
Later, Hera.
Kan kolaborasi adik kakak gitu loh.
Did you guys knew that Leander?
Itu like when you try to call her and she sounds like a vegetable. Call Leander.
Leander.
Okay, what's my name?
Leander.
Where have you seen my phone?
Oh, Yang Lean.
It's Leander.
Jauh.
Leander had a Japanese gamelan track on his recent official Spotify playlist. I fuck with that. Ini dong, kamu dong. Kan kita, we have a story about Yang Lean, right?
I have a story.
I was there.
Yeah, but you're not a fan. So
yo, I funny. Thought he was just some weird, like, Eastern European man wearing,
he
like...
He
is! Ugly banget.
That weird...
No, I don't like it.
Wearing embroidered jeans. Me Gucci, but honey.
No, it's Ed Hardy. It was great.
Oh, that's even worse! Yeah,
gak suka, no. Jangan like... katain Ed Hardy, no.
Okay.
No.
Katain Ed Hardy, katanya.
What?
She probably likes it.
So, gue selalu pakai Ed Hardy semuanya.
Okay. Maksud gue, lo kan beda bentukannya sama Yang Lean. Yang Lean bentukannya kayak...
Don't be offended, Miss Brenda.
Kayak manusia. Kayak bouncer gitu bentuknya.
Lakak banget, ya Allah.
Yang Lean bouncer. Terus kita ketemu di... Apa sih namanya? What's that fancy?
Agak nyet. Dia tuh kayak...
That fancy store. It wasn't that fancy.
DSM.
That's mean.
Kita lagi di DSM stands for Dover Street Market.
Dover Street Market.
Abis itu kayak Karim freaking out, kita kayak oh my god, that's Yang Lean. Okay, no way, that's probably not him. Like,
okay, I was skeptical.
Beneran gak sih?
Looks like at all. I just thought he was like probably a cool looking white man, not like that. Okay, gue kayak, really? Gitu kayak weird. Terus rambutnya
Tapi
beneran Yang Lean atau enggak? Have you guys like verified?
Oh, gue yang motret, terus gue kayak gue foto gak ya? Enggak deh, gue gak ngerti kayak.
Tadi apa sih namanya? Udah nih, kayaknya udah kelar deh, gak tahu diapain. Oke. Gitu. Karim udah selesai, Karim?
Udah.
Boleh share gambarnya, Karim?
Sure thing. I suppository.
Udah lebih dekat lagi, wow. Itu boleh jelasin gimana, wow. Demi apa? Cepet banget gambar kayak gitu.
Wow. Yeah, I'm pretty proud about this.
Wow, Miss Brenda, wow.
Yeah.
Miss Brenda gak nyangka murid Miss Brenda bisa sehebat itu ternyata. Sumpah.
Susah banget mendengar kata itu walaupun ini cuma kayak...
Kayak ternyata I'm good at teaching gitu loh. Wow.
We'll have a little talk after this, okay, Miss Brenda?
Oke, Karim, boleh tolong jelasin ini gambarnya gimana by showing it again. Jadi kayak lock sini.
Oke.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Terus jelasin, tunjukin ini apa artinya, ini lagi sorry. Apa.
Can I scoot? Aku nggak mau.
Destroy work. Okay, so there's no title for this, I suppose. Cuman, it's like this guy is just like crushing his own head because of his anxiety, and you can see like part of the head is oozing from his fingers. It's kind of melting away into his hand gitu. And yeah, I guess mukanya emang stres aja. There's no explaining that. He's just sweating because he's stressed out. And the mouth is a door because he is unable to talk during these strange times aja because he's angry. And
terus yang buka pintunya siapa?
Nobody.
Oh, that's sad.
Unless he needs 20 bucks from an alleyway.
He's a poor.
Yeah, I'm not good. 20 bucks. Either. Yeah, and like I guess the scissor is just like he's refusing to listen to anybody's advice at this point because like it's the whole self-righteousness of like facing everything by yourself. I did it again for me. The lip is bete banget aku ini.
Menarik. Ini nggak ada nilai untuk kayak gini-ginian. Ini udah kayak nilainya semua sama dan equal. Bagus.
Yeah.
Nilai. You should never give nilai out in an art class. That's what I believe in.
Yeah, that's true.
Makanya kayaknya gue nggak progress.
An art school is kind of weird.
That is. Ah, suara siapa tuh? I'm sorry
what?
Woo! Not the unsolicited dick pic. No, not at all.
Sebelum nge-share yang gambar orang lain, boleh lihat gambarnya Ula dulu mungkin?
Okay, gua gambar dua. Freak tapi enggak jelas. Okay, yang pertama, gambarnya kartun-kartun enggak jelas doang.
So cute.
One is a girl who's angry, but also she's touching her boobs. Is PMS?
I wouldn't know.
PMS. When you have PMS, your boobs hurt. Mm-hmm. The other one, ini kayak lo berdoa because like you really want this shit to end.
Berdoa.
Thing two, which is nyambung ke belakang. Lo jadi kayak you're looking for God at this time.
Wow.
Itu
storytellingnya ya.
Kan nyambung.
Make this
keren banget ya.
Make this storytelling.
Wow.
Mencari Tuhan.
Coba lagi tadi yang belakang belum jelas.
Nes
sebelumnya.
You're nasty.
Terus Brenda bangga banget dengan kalian.
Makasih ya.
Sumpah benar-benar Miss Brenda kayak deserve a lot nilai Miss Brandanya.
Oh my god.
Okay. Kalau ini gambar Miss Brenda, tadi Miss Brenda mencoba untuk catch up dengan kalian, jadi kurang bisa fokus dalam ngobrol dan dalam gambar. Dua-duanya nggak bisa fokus. Ini Miss Brenda lagi sedih ceritanya. Miss Brenda sedih lagi di kasur Miss Brenda. Lagi mikirin bracelet, kayak gitu.
Bracelet.
Karena waktu itu Miss Brenda lagi ada reuni sama teman-teman kantor Miss Brenda. Abis itu pas Miss Brenda lagi nari poco-poco, gelang Miss Brenda hilang. Jadi
kenapa
sekarang masih sedih.
Oh dia, this is not real, remember? This is not real. That was like really fucking me up just now. Okay. What is she doing poco-poco, man? Kayak.
It's the art, right? It's the story behind the art.
Yeah, it's Miss Brenda, though.
Oh
It's meta.
Super meta.
Oh damn! You just went like full John Malkovich.
In a different dimension, like she's coming from a different dimension right
now. That was like a fusion bit right there.
John Malkovich. It's like what? Ya, pokoknya kayak gitu. Oke, Miss Brenda mau ngelihat yang udah.
Komen.
Art block. What's an art block?
I think it's like a writer's block, most of it.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. How do you deal with art block?
For me, my friend kayak recommended me that kayak whenever I have like a producer block or like a writer's block or an art block, I kind of like go to the other like interests that I have that I've been neglecting. So like yeah, misalnya if I can't like make beats or write, you know, I'll try to watch movies or just read about some Wikipedia shit and kayak just weird stuff like sci-fi books or like I don't know. Gue yang kayak gue ingat, I kind of like really went deep in H.P. Lovecraftian ini God Wikipedia gitu. I don't know why. Terus kayak I was like, wow, these are interesting gitu. And like it kind of like pushed me and like motivated me to draw more like fluidly. So like kan kalau H.P. Lovecraftian ceritanya kan you can't really like picture the physicality of the monsters and the gods gitu loh, because you'll go mad when you do. So it kind of like it kind of pushed me like, oh okay, maybe if I draw more fluidly and like nggak dipikir-pikirin amat, maybe it'll end up being more sincere gitu loh.
Yeah.
I was trying to envision for me. I don't know. What about you?
I watch a lot of movies. That's about it. I watch like at least like... This is kind of pathetic. This is really pathetic actually. Like at least I watch like 3 to 4 a day. Nggak aku bawa, Mam. Sorry guys.
Nggak ada kepala charger,
Mam. Ada di...
Oopsie.
Sorry, that's the mother. Yeah, I watch a lot of movies. Okay, give me a minute.
just fun fact, Ula is a major movie buff. Ula sekalian ambil charger, Ula. Ambil laptop. Ula lobe.
Sebenernya sering ngeliat sih kalau misalkan Ula lagi kayak di rumah santai-santai doang, selalu kayak di posternya lagi nonton film ini, lagi nonton witchcraft, lagi berdoa witchcraft, lagi apa.
I think like for me, like my obsession is towards music. Oh, charger, oh sorry, robek. Charger lu nggak bisa nih.
I know.
Yeah, for me it's like music. I like if I talk about music, I'll end up getting really geeky and nerdy, and like that's the same thing with Ula gitu loh when it comes to movies, because like you know when I talk about music to Ula, she doesn't understand anything, and vice versa gitu when Ula's trying to talk about movies most of the time. And I was just saying kita tuh we both geek out over different things, tapi kayak you're kalau kamu tuh dengan film, kalau aku tuh dengan musik, and whenever we talk about shit like that we cannot really like understand each other's world because like it's already too far in, on the rabbit hole gitu loh.
I don't listen to a lot of music. I'm very musically challenged.
Tapi kan bukan berarti kita nggak ngerti, kita nggak bisa sharing. Kayak dimana kalau misalkan kita sharing sesuatu.
It's hard to get into things. You know what I mean? Kayak when we each of us recommend things. Kayak misalnya gue rekomend dia untuk kayak lo nonton ini deh gitu. He's not gonna watch it, dude. Kayak of course he's not. Karena he's not into it. Kayak dia kasih kayak oh nih dengerin ini deh. Gue kayak okay, cool, gitu kayak, I'm not into it, ngerti gak sih kayaknya?
Yeah.
I think we both kind of like, udah itu, udah terjun bebas terlalu dalam gitu loh ke
masing-masing.
Jadi kayak, whenever we want to talk about it, it's hard to say it in like a way that kind of like, she can get it or I can get it, gitu, I guess eh. Mungkin eh. Maybe Ula's talking about the metaphor in this movie and like, she's really going in it and like, kayak,
you know, good talk. Tapi kayak watched it. I haven't watched it. You know, I cannot understand. Sedangkan kayak I'm just talking about frequencies and like
pedals. I'm like, always kayak, to talk about pedals, and I don't understand one bit, and I'm not interested in it, but I'll still listen to it. You know what I mean?
Yeah. It's just a matter of respecting. Gua
ngerti banget at all.
Yeah.
Itu.
Tapi we do have irisan juga sih, honestly.
Apa sih maksudnya irisan?
Irisan obrolan gua kayak gini-giniin.
Oh, maksudnya Venn diagram tengahnya gitu. Ya ada.
Tapi
ya nggak apa-apa nggak sih kalau misalnya kayak okay, mungkin masing-masing udah kayak sangat terjun dari satu sama lain. Tapi kayak faktanya kita kayak coba cerita kayak okay, at least kita tahu kayak a bit dari kayak perspektif pas kayak okay, gue tahu. Tapi ya udah. Tapi sebatas tahu aja.
Tapi
gak harus kayak ngerti atau ngerasain juga.
We got into stuff at the same time.
I mean to be fair, like Ula's the cooler like.
Well, when I was in junior high, sure. Tapi maksudnya kayak we got into things at the same time. Jadi kayak whatever I liked, he liked, and then whatever he liked, he told me, and then I would probably like it. Kayak jadi back and forth. Ya zaman dulu lah itu.
Oh,
yeah,
look at that.
Itu tadi pertanyaan dari penonton ya?
Penonton.
Sure. Why are you bleeding?
Oh, art block ya? Udah kejawab belum sih tadi? Oh, that was
yeah, art block.
Yes.
Aiman mentorem.
Aiman Zaki. Itu
gak ada. Wah, itu muka gambarnya Karim The Hobbit New Zealand banget.
Oh, Hobbit New Zealand.
Kan itu ceritanya di New Zealand, Rim.
Tapi usah.
The Hobbit Indonesia is big me, man. The Hobbit Indonesia is just a...
BTW, guys, ini ada dua orang yang kirim gambar.
Yeah, dude. What are you talking about? Yeah, mana?
Ada tiga orang yang kirim gambar. Kita lihat yuk bareng-bareng. Ayo kita judge bareng-bareng. Gimana lu ya? Yang pertama dari Alfi namanya. Nih, dia gambar belajar gambar episode 2 bersama gue. Oke, okay, not okay. Waduh, ini kenapa nih? Let's destroy the galaxy with pollution. Ceritanya.
Let's destroy the galaxy. Oh, itu belakangnya galaxy.
Itu galaxy. Jadi lagi ngerokok di galaxy gitu ya. Wow. Lagi ngerokok kayak wow. Wow.
Can't imagine me. I'm like moving.
Terus ya. Oh, apa ya?
Kayak minta koreng lagi di luar gitu.
Serem banget, tapi serem banget kayak gitu. Alfi, kalau boleh misalkan jelasin sedikit juga, kasih tahu dong kenapa ini menarik sekali nih, bisa ada metafor-metafor yang lain mungkin ya. Thank you Alfi. Kita stop yang ini, kita lihat yang lain. Aduh, lapar banget.
Masa ya ingin rumah mulu nih?
Lapar banget.
Ini instan. Okay.
Modern Alfie ya. Oh,
nih, Rem La. Ada yang bikin namanya Nomoremudo. Tidak ada batasan. Sakit sendiri. Yoi.
Abstract expressionism.
Ya, ini abstract expressionism. Menarik banget. Thank you banget, Nomore. Gak bisa baca. Nomore Mudo.
Modern art.
Bisa jelasin juga dong, ini kayak tentang apa? Apakah kamu merasa seperti raja dengan memakai mahkota? atau kamu merasa lagi ada di dunia Aztec, belakangnya Aztec-Aztec, atau kayak terinspirasi dari siapa, bisa kasih tahu ya.
Mungkin ini
jam 3 pagi, jam 3 pagi.
3 ayam lah ya tadi ngomongnya, anjir. 3 ayam.
3 ayam.
3 ayam tuh bandnya temen gue. Check them out. Ya, mungkin itu kan kayak 3 jam.
Sekarang ada kiriman dari Putih kayak, I know, because I'm turning 26 and it's COVID, my friends can't surprise me. Ini siapa nih ceritanya? Ini siapa yang lagi berulang tahun nih? Happy birthday. Special shout out untuk orang yang di belakang Tiny, orang yang nge-operate di belakang ini juga, sahabat Brenda, teman dekat Brenda, dan partner Brenda. Selamat ulang tahun untuk Kata Bill. Gitu.
Oh, Rata yang ulang tahun, doi.
Rata.
Oh. Yeah, happy birthday.
Selamat ulang tahun.
Wow, God.
Ada. Ya, itu kan tadi udah.
Nice. Terus apa lagi? Ada lagi ya?
1, 2, 3. Yang... sekarang dari orang yang lagi berulang tahun ngirim gambar juga nih, just angry. Oh,
beneran sih nih
tulisannya, hanya marah.
Smile.
Menarik ya, kalian kalau misalkan inget satu monster robot yang ada di Powerpuff Girls atau Dexter, ini mirip banget ya.
Kayak him.
Oh, gak sih? him bener banget. Powerpuff Girls ya.
Him is the devil. She sounds like it's a she.
I think it's a she. It's she, he.
Okay, we can
delve. Itu dari mana tapi?
Like a full blown analysis on why.
Kalau boleh, kalau boleh dijelasin, Ratabil juga kasih tahu ya kenapa angry-nya. Apakah tadi kata Putih kayak benar? Ada yang lagi berulang tahun marah nggak bisa disukain temennya? Atau angry aja? Terima kasih, Ratabil.
Ratabil mau joget.
Maaf, angry.
Sama-sama. Aku
ada voice from above, Big Brother.
Ada Big Brother?
Brother.
Ada Big Brother.
Di Big Brother.
Oke, mungkin kita udah mulai menutup ya dengan terakhir nih ngelihat komen-komen di YouTube. Kalau ada.
Ada Frau tuh baru ngomong tuh, Frau. Shout out to Frau.
Akhirnya Frau muncul.
Dia kurang asik sih gak nonton dari awal. You're a traitor.
Bahkan dari minggu lalu, Frau gak mau support Miss Brenda loh. Frau gak nontonin Miss Brenda dari minggu lalu.
Hey, you're
Frau is cancelled.
Your self-pity nanti aja udah.
When Frau the is
cancelled. Karim, ya udah nih, baca nih. Bang sih singkatan. Oh udah, dari baca.
Tinggal 25 yang nonton. Damn.
Tadi gak seru kok.
Seru.
It's fun.
Oh.
Ini udah jauh loh, udah gak ada relevan sih.
Kayaknya kalau baca komen pang-pang kan asik sih.
Eh, shit. I mean, Ula always wanted to make like a Portis head kind of thing.
I don't know, what a basic bitch.
Not really, I mean it could be cool. Could be cool, I suppose.
Yeah, tapi I can't sing unless you put like a bunch of reverb. Kayak
kita gak harus bisa nyanyi sih untuk nyanyi.
Yeah, kecuali bandnya Riot Girl gitu yang teriak-teriak dong ya. I hate my life, I wanna die.
Itu gak Riot Girl.
Itu stereotip.
Oh.
Terus jadi kalian ada yang mau kalian komentarin soal episode ini, atau kayak apa yang kalian udah ngerasain selagi gambar, kalian bisa share?
Bersyukur aja diajarin Mbak Brenda selama ini sih ya, lumayan sih.
Jadi ganti lagi jadi Mbak sekarang?
Iya, yeah. Umur lu soalnya gonta-ganti mulu dari...
Nah, dia kita pantas kita bilang dia ibu sih, dia pocok-pocok.
oh my god, that's nasty. Karim kemarin jatuh naik sepeda, terus dia, he's got a lot of plasma.
Kalau kayak, kalau kata temen gue, kalau ada koreng kita nyebutnya Krakatoa.
Krakatoa.
Kayak gendol gitu.
Iya sih, kayak meledak gitu. But you can smell your plaster.
Jadi snuff. One man, one plaster.
Kita lanjut lagi. Miss Brenda, tapi not safe for work.
itu mungkin menarik ya, yang untuk seumur umur Miss Brenda gitu kali ya. Sekarang kayaknya audiens kita anak-anak kecil soalnya.
Brenda kecil banget.
Nah, kayak umur 40-an ke atas gitu loh.
Kayak
ibu-ibu. Ya nanti lu kayak kalau ditua kayak klereng.
Anjing banget
kan. Kak Karim, kamu jadi gak sopan gini ya ngata-ngatain Miss Brenda gini? Sejak kapan kamu kayak gini ya? Dulu kamu tuh baik loh.
Badung gue jadi
baik. Tapi dulu kamu tuh baik sama Miss Brenda. Oke, jadi kita rangkum ya. Kita rangkum semuanya. Hari ini kita gambar emosi. Hari ini Ula gambar orang lagi berdoa karena lagi sakit PMS. Hari ini
abis itu mencari Tuhan.
Oh ya, abis itu mencari Tuhan. Kalau ya, kalau Karim hari ini gambar orang yang lagi garuk-garuk kepala buka pintu.
Ya, betul.
Ya, buka pintu dan gunting kupingnya sendiri. Jadi kalau misalkan ada yang mungkin masih belum selesai gambarnya karena gambar kalian terlalu rumit, terlalu bagus, pakai materi ini apapun segala macam, nggak apa-apa, tetap aja kirim dan tag ke Tiny Studio, oke?
Okay? We appreciate your hard work.
We appreciate power. Ada satu pertanyaan terakhir yang Miss Brenda mau nanya nih buat ke kalian.
Oke.
Ada upcoming plans gitu enggak?
Ask a question.
Brin lagi nanya. Oke, gitu. Enggak ada yang tanyain dulu deh. Nurut.
Like mereka, iya, 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 iya. Gimana. Bun. Ya, Bun.
Ada kayak upcoming plans gitu enggak yang kayak mau di-share ke kita dan ke dunia dan ke audience?
Maaf.
Sebelum kita kayak rap semuanya.
What album this year? Aku sih itu aja sih, I guess. Yeah.
Album.
Yeah. And to not seeing the end of the world anytime soon, hopefully.
Yeah. But yes. That's seru.
Akhirat siap. Get away.
Not ready for that yet.
Yeah, bye-bye alam. Bimbo gitu apa sih?
Enak.
Jadi lebih ke album ya untuk.
Yeah, for me it's an album and for Ula, hopefully motherfuckers start to see her our work as being not just drawings but actually genuinely good art.
No, but I see my work as not art. I actually see it as illustration. It's fine. It's very different.
Yeah, but like.
It's very different and it's okay. It's not.
It deserves the attention.
Kenapa Ula nggak mau kayak menganggap itu sebagai art emang?
Nggak tahu ya. Karena gue kerja di lingkungan seni juga, jadi so I have like a conceptual thought about what fine art is. Oh, dan kayak it's very different from what I do. Kayak jadi I'm okay with lowbrow and like ilustrasi aja, kayak fine aja gue. I love like that. Bad things. I love like bad stuff. Jadi kayak it's fine for me. Apa ya yang gue ngapain?
Oh. Miss Brenda dapat notification. Ada yang kirim gambar lagi. Dicek dulu ya sebelum kita mengakhiri call ini.
Kamera Brenda bagus banget.
Sebelum. Apanya Brenda?
Your webcam quality is like top notch.
Kan Miss Brenda tinggal di luar, internetnya bagus.
Yeah. That's true, because I heard kamu yang bilang aku ya wifi kita paling rendah sedunia. Oh no, Rio told me that. Jadi kayak wifi kita tuh di Indonesia paling rendah sedunia.
Kenapa?
Maksudnya di Southeast Asia, bukan di dunia.
Masih Indonesia, emang Indonesia masih di atas kayak Kamboja atau kayak...
Enggak, katanya enggak. Kita tuh paling rendah, that's why kayak gini nih.
Oke, ini kita dari dapat gambar dari Becca from Finance.
Becca. Hi Becca.
Iya betul, kamu betul dan gambar kamu sangat representasikan Miss Brenda. Wow,
Miss Brenda gemes.
True. Aduh malu.
Good job Becky.
Thank you Becca, Becky for drawing this. Gimana ya? Ada yang bisa, ada yang mau kalian review soal gambar ini nggak?
Is that a heart?
Jantung.
Yeah, that's jantung with the tubes coming out.
Yeah.
That's a hurt heart.
Iya, apa namanya, hatinya kayak emang keriput gitu, kayak, oh soalnya belakangnya lagi ngerokok, jadi hatinya emang keriput mungkin ya, jadi kayak...
Bisa jadi.
Nah, seharusnya kan paru-paru itu ya, tapi ya udah, gak apa-apa.
Iya!
juga ada apel ya, maksudnya apel marah ke awan ya, gitu. Nge-reviewnya jelek
banget. Awannya... ngerokok.
Right.
Awan yang ngerokok.
Right.
Thank you. This is a very nice drawing, Becky or Becca. Kalau Becky kayak so terlalu sok kenal kali ya. Tapi nggak apa-apa. Thank you.
Awan Becky.
Oh, sama terakhir lagi. Oh, kita dapat gambar dari orang yang kadang kita sayang, kadang kita benci. Namanya Frau, seniman kita langsung.
Yo.
Spiny. Yo.
Are you
ini
okay?
Lagi. Oh my god, Frau, you wanna kill a person?
You okay, Frau?
You feeling manslaughtery?
Miss Brenda gak mau GR ya, tapi Miss Brenda takut kalau ini Miss Brenda yang ditembak deh.
Ini kayak preteen bubbles gitu ya?
Wow. Iya, poninya mirip kayak Bubbles.
Is that the professor trying to kill Bubbles?
Iya, soalnya berbulu tangannya ya.
Underage.
Iya. Frau gets abused. Siapa juga? Dan kenapa kayak gini?
Abis dari Prabatan?
Perempatan.
Perempatan. I don't know what you were talking about.
Gimana untuk Ula yang pernah menjadi kuratornya Frau di review?
Frau, semangat terus berkarya. Animasi-animasi lanjut terus. Serius.
Kalau gambar tadi juga.
It's just yours. He sounds so
cynical. Aduh.
He's cynical because he's a little bitch.
Ya, sebagai kuratornya, Ula emang berhak untuk ngomong seperti itu. Tapi juga sebagai gurunya, Miss Brenda berhak untuk ngomong, kamu harus lebih belajar ya.
Aduh, mampus.
We need that panic titties and vajayjay frau again, right?
Hati-hati ya Karim juga, gak boleh ngomong seperti itu di channel ini.
Sorry. Ini keep things PG-13 nih.
Kan PG. Ntar kita kalau bikin yang baru lagi, yang PG-40 ke atas.
PG-40 ke atas, anjing. Foto yuk.
Aduh,
soalnya background-nya ada image-nya itu loh.
Aduh.
Foto party. Tapi gak usah bilang. Oke. Ula kalau mau misalkan tadi belum mendapat fotonya, foto sekarang karena Miss Brenda udah harus cepet-cepet mandi.
Brenda dulu.
Anjing, kayak guru beneran ya fotonya.
Hah, maksud kamu apaan? Kan emang guru beneran.
Yes.
Oh, kalau guru cowok tuh yang senyumnya tuh yang kayak...
Oke.
Okay. Biasanya kayak gitu kalau foto sama ini siswa, tapi kalau udah ke gereja hari Minggu, gitu.
What school did you go to?
No, Ali.
What school did you go to?
Aku nggak
bergaul
sama
aku.
Oke, okay, guys, okay. Maaf banget kalau misalkan Miss Brenda harus ngepotong percakapan kalian, tapi beneran Miss Brenda harus pergi sekarang.
Iya, yeah. Oke, okay, Nanny McPhew.
Kurang mall di sini.
Iya.
Yeah. Oke. Okay. Kalau hilang juga.
Without my fire, it's lit.
Lagi ketawa beneran.
Iya, kalian, oke, okay, harus berubah. Kalian terima kasih yang sampai sekarang masih stick with us dan ada di YouTube ini. Sebenarnya nggak bisa ngelihat dari sini ada berapa orangnya, tapi untuk kalian semua yang masih ada, terima kasih. Dan terima kasih juga yang sudah kirim gambar, komentar-komentar, dan sharing-sharing atau bercanda-bercanda. Makasih atas partisipasinya. Dan juga untuk Ula dan Karim, terima kasih banget kalian di sini udah menjadi kakak beradik yang sangat akur, yang sangat edgy, yang sangat dark juga. Kita sebagai Tiny Studio kayak senang sekali ada kalian di sini karena akan kayak mengharumkan nama Tiny Studio biar jadi lebih edgy juga seperti kalian.
Yeay.
Dan untuk Ula dan Karim juga sukses-sukses ke depannya ya.
Siap.
Amin.
Makasih Bu Brenda.
Buat kalian.
Hati-hati ya.
Jangan sedih-sedih juga waktu karantin. Jangan. Dan banyak hal kalau misalkan gak di-stopin, mungkin Brenda juga gak akan stop. Jadi.
Lanjut.
Udah gak ada jadi lagi, ntar susah stopnya.
Oke.
Okay.
Okay. Bye.
Terima kasih semuanya.